Hirap ka ba mag-save and invest? Particularly OFW ka. Kasi syempre, hindi ibig sabihin kumikita ka ng dollar, ng baht, or whatever currency. Ang dami mo ng pera. And syempre, ang dami mo rin tinutulungan sa Pilipinas. Ano yung mga technique para hindi mo magastos yung hard-earned money mo? Watch this video to learn more on how to save.
May question ulit ako kasi as we have been talking, encouraging the OFWs, but there are also people who are in the Philippines, mm-hmm. not necessarily naging OFW sila, but they are in a 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. job. And maganda yun, blessing yun. Like ako, when I was in a job na ganun, I learned a lot. Pero syempre, gusto natin yung financial independence, flexibility, like what you are enjoying now in your life. Any tips to the Filipinos na they want to be in business and investments? Kasi syempre, majority of our kababayans, their major source of income is their work. So any tip, advice for them to have that flexibility? Yes.
That's a very nice question. Thank you for that, Neil. You know, 9-to-5 job is something like, even if we're working 9-to-5 job and you just really want to focus that on that because it's giving you a fixed stream of income, that's actually very good. However, for us to be successful, it's what we do after the 9-to-5 job. So it's what we do after 6, 7 p.m., 8 p.m., 9 p.m. Or are you the type of person after work, are you going to go home, watch Netflix or watch a TV series and go to sleep? Or are you the type of person that when you go home, after you've done the chores, you're the type of person who would read a book about investment or about savings? Or are you someone who meets people who are into investments? Or paano ba kikita? Or are you the type of person na kahit nag 9-to-5 job ka, after that, nag-o online selling ka? So it's again, making use of your time. It cannot be a reason na, okay, I'm not moving forward or closer to my dream. It's because I'm in a 9-to-5 job. Again, it's what we do after we work. There are a lot of venues. If you want to learn, even YouTube, there's a lot of lessons we can learn in YouTube. There are seminars now that you can learn for free online. Seminars that would run 1 hour, 2 hours, you know. There are also good books that we can read, start with. Or, you know, you could also do, like, you could also learn from the people around you. Online selling, for example, or maybe mahilig ka talaga sa sapatos, for example. Maybe you can start selling shoes, you know. Post it on Facebook instead of just browsing for an hour. Maybe you can spend 30 minutes to post that, right? So, again, it's what we do after the 9-to-5 job. I remember, as an example, when I used to fly, so I would fly, that was my steady income, but at the same time, after nag-check out na ako, after nag-sign out na ako, it was what I did after flying. So it was with Investusias, it was, you know, stock investing, it was really looking into, you know, areas where we could invest in real estate. So it was really spending time. And I remember when I was flying and we would be sleeping in, like, for example, I was in Germany, no? Everybody would go down, spend the night after dinner, drinking and all. I would go down, I would have dinner, I would maybe have a glass or two of wine. But then after that, I'd go up, I'd get my book, I'd read. Or I'd go open my laptop or my phone and then I'd look into TED Talks or mga seminars, yung ganon. So I always felt that, you know, I have to grow. Yes, I have a steady income, but I cannot live on this forever. Because again, it's positioning. I want a sustainable lifestyle. So I cannot just aspire and wait. No, I have to do something. It's the little things that I do that will, you know, accumulate in time. Whether it's just reading for 10 minutes or whether it's just watching a lesson about saving on YouTube for 10 minutes. But that's going to add value in my life. So again, it's what you do after the 9-to-5 that will enable you to be free of that 9-to-5 job when you want to in the future. Yeah.
Indeed. Because people will just say, hindi, wala akong oras nila eh. Kasi sa commute, ano, nauubos na yung time ko. Pero even in that commute, while going home after your 9-to-5 job, pwede ka mag-podcast eh. Pero
that's
minsan kasi, tini-TikTok lang kasi natin minsan eh. I mean, nothing wrong with TikTok, but if it consumes you at yun lang, sayang yung opportunity for you to grow. Parang si May, di ba?
Yes, you were, you know, you're right. You're right, actually, Neil. I remember, so there's podcasts now. Oh my gosh, there's so many good podcasts now. For sure, you do podcasting also, right, Neil? You do podcasting also. So there are a lot of good topics, great topics now, and just a click of your phone. I remember, for those who like reading books, tapos nagko-commute kayo, tapos feeling nyo nahihilo kayo pag nagbabasa ng libro, there's audiobooks, right, that you can just listen to it. You know, put your headphones on and, you know, drown out the noise. But after an hour, you're a much better person because you learn a new skill or you learn a new insight. So there's always opportunity. Kahit mag-browse sa Facebook, there's always opportunities. You know, oh, what can I sell? Ano ba pwede kong ibenta? Ano bang yan? And having said that, Nila, like if you want to enter into that stage, kasi it's normal to feel na, oh my gosh, ato, may 9-to-5 job ako. Ano kaya iisipin nila if magbebenta ako? Baka isipin nila wala akong pera. It's normal. Sometimes it might come to your mind na ayoko. Or say for example, magbebenta ba ako? Parang nahihiya naman ako. But let me tell you, if you really want to be successful, one of the characteristics of a successful person is someone who doesn't care about what other people think. So if you stay, pag sasabihin mo na, oh my gosh, ano kaya isipin mo? They're not gonna... Hindi nila sasabihin sa iyo na if you don't have money, not everyone's gonna help you. But if you have the money, people are gonna ask you how did you do it. But again, if you want value, it's that value of not really listening to what other people think. Kasi if yung hiya will be, you know, stronger than our desire to make money, then you know, it's gonna be difficult. So, you look into the entrepreneur, sino ba yung mga successful people? Uy, ang kakapal ng mukha. In a good sense, you know, like there's someone who, they don't care kahit mag-online selling, but they're making so much money, di ba? So, when I look at friends or like maybe batchmates doing online selling, for me, I'm like, oh my goodness, good on you. Bibili ako. Because I know it's not easy, but there they are hustling. And, you know, the entrepreneurs who really make it big are those people who don't care about what other people think. Yeah.
Hashtag respect those people,
yes,
who are
selling. Yes.
Kasi may mindset pagka nagbibenta, parang mababa yung status eh. And
yeah,
that's a fallacy, a misconception. If ayaw mong to look bad in the eyes of people, nasa iyo yun. Pero to begin with, people don't care about your life eh. So just do what makes you happy and add value to people and be a blessing. Sometimes it's hindering us eh. Ay, ayoko mag-business or magbenta ng ganito kasi baka ano yung isipin ni na Mare or ni person. Eh, so what with that person, di ba? It's your life. We don't,
yes,
want to live our lives based on how they will think of us. So what kung nagkamali tayo? So what kung hindi pa tayo magaling? Pero nandun,
yeah,
eh. Nandun yung greatness as you start. Siyempre, we will always start with humble beginnings.
Yes.
Siguro may question pa ako, no? Kasi as we have talked about, yun nga, going out of the 9-to-5. Again, ha, if you, disclaimer lang, hindi natin goal to go out of the 9-to-5,
yes,
ng lahat ng tao. There are people who are destined, called sa 9-to-5 job, they're fulfilled and happy, so be it. But those,
yes,
people,
yes,
they want to go beyond, then hopefully these tips can help,
yes,
you. Siguro,
right,
as we have been talking about investments and you have the time with your family, flexibility, how do you balance? I think question ko, how do you balance pursuing your dreams, your passion, the things that you love, also saving and investing and being disciplined and with all your passion? Siyempre, it entails cost din. Although nagkwento ka naman na yung sa budgeting, pero how do you balance all of that na nagagawa mo pa rin in a way living a full life? Yon.
Wow. Very interesting. Palalim ng palalim, Neil. Palalim ng palalim yung question.
Hindi na tayo dito mamaya.
For me, I think it's priorities. I go down to priorities. Who's number one for me? What's number one for me? Definitely number one, it's my family. Okay, of course, there's God, but my number one priority is my family. Second is then my job. next would be whatever comes. But it's always, sa kahit sa dalawa na lang yan, my first priority is my family, second would be my job, or the investments that we make, or the money, the value of money. So when it comes to decision making, say for example, I need to like look at a certain itong investment na to, kailangan akong glued dito sa computer from 9 to 12, for example. Example lang ha. But I know that my son is going to have his moving up ceremony. I will not think twice. Hindi ako mag-iisip na baka pwede kong i-cancel, hindi na lang ako makatid. No, my first priority is my family. I'm gonna go. My first priority is my son. It's easy for me to say, hindi pwede. I'm gonna be with my son. So it's always about priorities. And I think in life, there's no such thing as total balance. I don't believe that there's a total balance, but I believe in priorities. Because some, it, you know, like there's a time we're in, say for example, you have to choose between the two. As an example before, I needed to fly to Melbourne, but my son got, you know, very high fever. So my priority was again my family, and the next was my job. So I didn't even think twice na should I call sick or not. No, he's sick, I'm gonna call sick. He's my first priority. I remember that also with my husband when we were, I think, newly married, and then I asked him, I was so sick, pero closing kasi he's an accountant. He had to be in the office. And I knew pag nasa office siya, makakaalis na yon mga 11 na ng gabi kasi it was the month end. So kailangan mag-close nila. I was so sick because of flu. And then early morning, when he found out I was not really feeling well, he called in sick. Sabi ko, why? You know, it's month end nyo. And then he told me na, you know, 10 years from now, I'm not gonna regret if I missed the month end. But 10 years from now, I'm gonna regret if I'm not here beside you and something happens to you. So it was always priorities. And I think balance, it cannot be, because there will be times na I would need to be in the office for maybe 6 hours or 8 hours. I can't be with my son. Yes, there will be times like that. Or there will be times na I need to be with my son for 8 hours, tapos 2 hours lang sa whatever it is that I'm doing or sa investment na matutukan ko. But then again, those are normal days. It wouldn't always be equal na 4 hours dito, 4 hours dito. So I don't think there's an equality there, but I think there's priority. When the need arises, I know my priorities. So for example, when I come home from work, I cannot come home with 20% left energy battery sa sarili ko. I know that if I gave 100% in my work or in my consultancy work, when I come home, my son, my family deserves 100% of me as well. So it's always like that. Maybe there's a certain, is it tiring? It can be tiring, yes, but that's the choice you make, and you have to be accountable and responsible to stand up for the priorities in your life.
Yeah, your family is blessed to have you as the mother of your child and also wife to your husband. Blessed sila kasi talagang pinaglalaban mo eh. Agree ako na there's no such thing as balance na kailangan equal footing, but there are really moments where wala, you just have to spend time more and really to prioritize kung ano yung importante sa'yo. Hopefully, siguro yung masishare ko din, for those people who would want to really prioritize finances, investment, importante yan. Heart namin ni May yan in Stock Smarts, but I hope it should not be at the expense of your family and your health. Aanin mo yung sobrang dami ng pera pero parang hindi ka na kinikilala ng pamilya mo, di ba? Aanin mo yung mga milyones o bilyones mo if the people who are close to you don't respect you. Again, yun yung value namin. We hope that you can have that as well. So thank you, May, for sharing your life, sharing your heart into it,